have a bit of an advantage on the age thing in that, you know, I've been dancing since I was a teenager and I'm 41 now. So I've got the benefit of history, able to look back and see what it did for me in my life and think a bit more about the bigger picture, about what might be going on here, and that perhaps there's a lot more interesting stuff than the obvious about just the dance. Perhaps there's something much more deep and soul-searching and lasting for those people who call themselves B-boys and B-girls.
Tonight you're gonna see some breaking and some rapping and some breaking and some scratching and some breaking and some graffiti and some breaking, and then you're gonna see some more breaking.
Jail was something I saw in my cards. I saw it at an early age and I saw it coming. And I was warned on several occasions, if I didn't change the way I do things or put my energy to good use, that's where I would be. As far as that goes, breakdancing pretty well saved my life in so many ways. And the nice part about the group was it turned into an adoptive family for me, where I was able to look at other people and their ideas and work as a team. And I can only say that the Floor Masters did save my life and changed me forever.
To me, is bringing everyone from all different places together. Like, it's like a family. It's even better than being in a gang, because when I was younger, I used to We used to beat up kids and just, I used to be a troublemaker, obviously, you know what I mean? I still am, but.
There's a lot of aggression too, though. Like, we're still B-boys, we're aggressive, and it's like competitive, you know? But like, it's on the dance floor, so that's what's positive about it, you know? If you don't like someone, you just take him out, and you make it, and making the guy look bad in the circle in front of everybody is like almost better than kicking his ass, you know what I'm saying?
Way better. Stuff that was keeping me out of trouble, but it wasn't keeping me out, like, you know what I mean, 100%, like, because I didn't have to, like, all the time and effort to put into it. It was just stupid shit that was hanging out and, you know, just causing trouble and doing stupid things. And then as soon as, like, I saw B-boying, the whole thing just flipped me over, and, like, after that, it was, like, every day, 24/7, like, that's my focus, all my energy's in that.
Is something special for you.
Yo, I get all this, like, all this anger that's inside of me just out when I'm breaking, man. It feels so good.
Everything that's
and when
inside,
I'm done, it's like, I'm so tired, right? It's like, I feel like I achieved everything in life, you know what I mean? I just express myself to the fullest. At the same time, I was amazing myself, you know what I mean? It's just like, when you do a move that you've never done before, this feeling inside of you, it's like, you can't express it. It's just like, yo, yeah, that's the shit, you know what I mean? It's just the baddest thing you can do. I just think that it helps people out, man. Like, people meet each other, they have the same vibes, and they help each other, and they work shit out. And
being part of something gives you, helps you define your sense of identity. And when you're a B-boy, you find you've got all these things in common. And one of the key ones is sort of this passion for creativity and dance. But it's so refreshing to meet other people who share that creativity and sort of share that passion for the dance, which I also think comes out then later in a passion for life. The B-boy crew is an important place to start. It's your family, it's your familia, it's the people who have your back, it's the people you hang out with, and it's the people who share the same passion for the dance that you do. In the early days when B-boying was coming out of New York, you know, crews like New York City Breakers, Rocksteady Crew, Dynamic Rockers, these are some of the names that took B-boying to new levels in terms of an international reputation. And even though some of these old school cats may not dance anymore, you know, they still hang out once in a while and consider themselves tight family.
That's important. Like, I never grew up with my father. Like, I never had, like, a strong family value, you know what I mean? Things were never, like, tight like that. And I was always looking for ways, you know what I mean, to find, like, belonging, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, like, a lot of us here, you know, we were in gangs and we caused trouble and shit. You know what I mean? But when I started breaking, you know, I started to realize that a lot of people who danced were a lot like me, you know what I mean? They came from you know, poor housing, you know, broken homes, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Had problems with drugs and all types of things. And, you know, it gave me my sense of community, you know what I mean? And when I see people, you know what I mean? I meet other people, I was like, we're the same, you know what I mean? Because of the things we've been through, and that's why we dance.
Talking to my man, Coach Matthew Sparks, one of the original floor masters from Ottawa, Canada.
True.
How you doing, Matt?
Good.
So obviously we can tell by the background we're in London, England here.
For work. This is my home office for the time being.
What are you in town doing?
Well, I've been working with a Canadian circus company, Cirque du Soleil, for the last couple of years, coaching the European Tour.
The European Tour. And what are we doing tonight? We're going to the opening night?
Tonight's the opening night, the premiere of Cirque du Soleil here in London.
The Key Dam?
Key Dam. I have no doubt that b-boying was my first exposure to performance. Started b-boying with the floor masters, sort of early mid-80s sort of thing, and found in the crew kind of a support group. Immediate friends, became good tight friends with all the members of the crew, people who now I still hang out with to the day 15 years later, more than that, 20 years later, we're still tight.
Tell me some more.
All right. Well, it is life, but let me tell you something. I have to think of an answer and get back to you next week.
I got soul, and I'm super bad. Got the move that tells me what to do. Sometimes I feel so nice. I said I'm gonna try myself with you.